काँग्रेस अध्यक्ष राहुल गांधी यांनी आज पुण्यामध्ये विद्यार्थ्यांशी संवाद साधलाय. तसेच विविध मुद्द्यांवर विद्यार्थ्यांसोबत मनमोकळेपणाने चर्चा करत विविध प्रश्नांची उत्तरे दिली आहेत.
वेरी सिंपल. ओके, देयर इज अ नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. लेकिन इनका जो नाम है वो लेने से मैं थोड़ा शर्मा रहा हूं. इनका नाम ईशा है. तो अच्छा, ये जो एन ईशा है, न्यू लॉ कॉलेज BBALB सेमेस्टर 2 कहां पे है ये ईशा? ईशा,
ईशा टॉर्च के लाइट से तुझे ढूंढना पड़ेगा कि भाई कुठे
है. वेरी ईशा सर, क्योंकि मेरा एक टेलीविजन सीरियल चल रहा है, उसमें मेरे हीरोइन का नाम ईशा है, तो इसलिए मैंने
बोला. अरे शी इज हियर, यू आर वी फा.
अच्छा ईशा, हां,
समवेयर अप फ्रंट. कुठे का भाई?
हेलो, आस्क योर क्वेश्चन.
हाय सर,
हाउ आर यू?
आई एम फाइन, व्हाट अबाउट यू?
आई एम गुड.
सो माय क्वेश्चन इज, what is the future for women participation in politics?
33% of Lok Sabha, Vidhan Sabha, Rajya Sabha seats are going to be reserved for women after 2019 when we come to power. We are going to ensure that 1/3 of parliament, 1/3 of every Vidhan Sabha is guaranteed to have women in it. Second thing we are thinking about is 33% of all jobs at the national level should be reserved for women. Those are the broad ideas we have in our manifesto. And if you're interested in politics, please come and have a chat with me. We'll try and bring you into Vidhan Sabha or Lok Sabha, wherever we can. Are you interested in politics?
No, you're not interested. Really.
Come and talk to me, we'll make you interested.
Sure. Okay, thank you, sir.
What do you want to do?
Basically, I'm doing BBLLB first year right now, but not yet planned for the future.
Do you think you're going to look for a job or
corporate.
Start your business? Corporate?
Yeah.
Any particular area?
Not as such. Okay, thank you, sir.
Thank you, Isha. The girls are blushing as well, Rahul, around you.
The other thing you would have noticed, you know, talking about women empowerment, I'm happy to see that women are sitting in the front over here and men at the back.
The men are very upset with
it. It's an important thing. I think women need to be given space in business. They need to be given space in politics. And they need to be part of the conversation. That's why I'm happy that you're sitting here in front of everybody.
All right, ladies, 1 point for you. But the next one is a gentleman, Rahul. This one is Yash Seth from New Law College. Yash Seth, where are you? Are you a popular boy? Because they'll find you and throw you upwards. How many of you remember standing outside ATMs trying to get your money out like some time back? This question is about the demonetization. And I hope we find him. Oh, the boys are up front. All right. Yash, how did you make it to the front of the stage?
Hello, sir.
Good job.
Hello.
So my question is that India is still reeling from the effects of note-bandi. So how can this be revealed from the, how can be India be revealed from this jammed economy?
Well, first of all, unfortunately, note-bandi or demonetization was a disastrous idea. Taking 500 rupees and 1,000 rupees and just removing them from the economy. You can ask any economist you want, that's a disaster. And it had a terrible effect on the economy. 2% of GDP was lost, millions of jobs were lost, and the economy jammed shut. Frankly, there's nothing that can be done about demonetization now. The damage has already been caused. So there's not much that can be done. But as far as job creation is concerned, there are a couple of ideas that we're working on that will seriously improve the job situation. Number one, as I've said, currently the Indian banking system is completely controlled by 15-20 people. Nirav Modi, Mehul Choksi, Anil Ambani. If you're an entrepreneur, you don't have access to bank loans. So we want to give access to lots of young entrepreneurs to the banking system, to bank loans, so that they can start their businesses. That's one. Second thing is, when a youngster in Pune wants to open a business, first thing he has to do is he has to take permissions from different government departments. Go to one department, please give me this permission, another department, third department, fourth department. Every department you go to, you have to pay a little bribe. So by the time you start your business, you're already done. So what we've done in our manifesto, which is a revolutionary idea, we've said that if any youngster wants to start a business, for 3 years, he or she doesn't have to take permission from anybody, any government department for anything. You go start your business. Once you've started your business, take your time, spend 3 years doing your business. If your business is successful, if you've got some employees, 20, 30 employees, then come to the government department for permission. So we want to remove that hassle from you. Second thing, third thing, 22 lakh government jobs are lying empty. India needs to build a education infrastructure, healthcare infrastructure, and it needs to build public government institutions that are good and effective. So we are going to increase our expenditure on education and on healthcare. We're going to take our educational expenditure to 6% of GDP. And in order to run these institutions, we're going to require lots of people. So 22 lakh jobs will be filled to fulfill the challenges of universal healthcare and education. There's another 10 lakh jobs that we can create at the panchayat level in the rural areas. So that right there is 33 lakh jobs, and that's easy. Once we do the NYAI scheme and we pump money into the economy will start, production will start, and you will see that jobs will start up again. But the sad part is that demonetization, frankly, nothing can be done. It's like a injury that we have sustained and we are going to have to carry with us.